We were quiet last week, but oh yeah, we're more than making up for it on this week's show. As you can see, we've got some great new products here on the bench to go over. We're going to start with this guy here. I know this is one that I've been waiting for. A number of you folks out there have been waiting for. Ian, you can leave me alone and stop bugging me now. Yes, it's official. There is a new Spitfire here from ParkZone. As you can see, it is larger than the last version of the Spitfire. And it's a great looking plane. I've had a chance to see it fly. I haven't had a chance to fly it myself yet, but there's just a lot of details they've gone into this. It's got the little antenna tower towards the back of the cockpit. There's gauges on the dashboard of the cockpit. You've got the radiator vents. You've got cannons on the front end of this thing, and you can use optional retracts on this plane. Very, very cool. We headed out to Eli Field recently to meet up with Matt Andren, the man behind the new Spitfire Mk IX from ParkZone.
Matt Andren from ParkZone here, showing off the new ParkZone Warbird. It's been a long time in coming. You guys have asked for it. Gary Katzer's inferred about it once or twice in his podcast, but here it is, the new ParkZone Spitfire. This thing is just gorgeous. You guys are going to love this one a lot. This one just is loaded with scale details all over the place. I mean, you got the cannon blisters, you got the panel lines, the antenna, you got the works on this thing. I mean, it's scaled out really nice. This particular airplane is modeled in Johnny Johnson's trim scheme, who is a very popular, famous British ace from World War II. He flew a number of different Spitfires throughout the war, and this is one of his more popular rides. It's done up in the traditional three-tone British color scheme with the dark gray and green, and then the light gray undersides. Just a gorgeous airplane, really looks the part in the air, flies amazing. You guys are really going to love this one. And of course, we couldn't leave you without optional E-flite retracts. It's set up for it right out of the box. Just drop in four screws and you're ready to go. It just really completes this airplane. Just like I said, just tons of detail on this one. I mean, you got the cannons on it, you got the cannon blisters. It's just going to be a fantastic airplane, and we think you guys are going to love it a lot. It's available in two different completion levels. You have the traditional bind and fly and plug and play completion levels like you've seen for most of the Warbirds and stuff from ParkZone, and should be available in probably about a month. So the ParkZone Spitfire here is equipped with the exact same power system as the ParkZone P47, and if any of you guys have that one, you know that's a really potent power system, and being that this is a pretty clean airframe, it really gets it moving, and you'll see that in the video. Has a 2200 battery, 30 amp E-flite controller, and then the 15 size outrunner motor. So also uses the T28 props, a very common components that are out there. Just really, really makes the airplane the part, just flies excellent.
Thanks a ton, Matt. And like I say, you guys, this is just a great flying plane. You will not be able to wait to get your hands on it. Pre-orders are available now, and I highly recommend you go ahead and do so. You're going to want some extra batteries. Pick up those retracts, too. That'll be pretty cool. Also new this week, in a follow-up to the 22 from Team Losi Racing, their cousins over at Losi now have a 22 ready to run. And what they've done is they've taken it, they've comboed everything up for you to make it even easier to get up and running, but you don't have to go out and buy all the separate components. The chassis comes out of the box pre-assembled for you. It includes a 13-turn sensored brushless motor and a programmable electronic speed controller. Comes with red compound taper pins in the front and red compound BK bars in the rear. Overall, just a really cool package available in two different colors. And it also includes a Spectrum DX3E transmitter. So very cool setup here. We caught up with Andy Ziegler from Losi to get more information on the 22 ready to run.
Gary, thanks again for having me. Once again, my name is Andrew Ziegler here with Losi. We've got an exciting new product coming to you guys. This is the 22 RTR from Losi, not to be mistaken with the TLR22 kit. This little bad boy is ready to run and from Losi. You'll notice it looks very similar to the 22 kit version from TLR because it is based on that vehicle, which has been race proven over and over and continue to win races around the world. I kind of just start off with some of the major features of this vehicle to kind of lead right into it. First of all, it's roar legal right out of the box. The only thing you're going to need to purchase to get this thing going is going to be a battery and obviously a charger for that battery. Otherwise, this thing is ready for roar legal competition. Slap it down, go, and you're good. The next would be that it comes with a brushless system. It is a 13.5 turn sensored system. So there's, you know, you're good to go right there as far as a race standpoint with the brushless system. Comes with, obviously, Spectrum 2.4 DSM technology. Comes with the DX3E transmitter, the SR300 receiver already installed in there, good to go. Take the body off here. You'll notice, like the TLR version, it has an aluminum chassis. Chassis is just a little bit different than the race version, but it is aluminum, good to go there. The same size big bore shocks, a bigger size for a 10 scale vehicle. We also have a gear differential in there. It's sealable as well, so you can tune that thing. Some of the major differences between the two. First would be the chassis. Between the TLR version and the Losi version would be the chassis is a little bit different material, like I told you. Some of the material in the plastics is a little bit different. As far as the design, everything goes, it's exactly the same. Like I said, it has a gear differential as opposed to the ball differential. The version here, the RTR version, comes with wheels and tires. The tires come pre-mounted, all glued up, ready to go. We got BK bars and taper pins already installed. One of the big things with the Losi version is the replacement parts. There's going to be very few that come under the Losi brand. The majority of those replacement parts are going to come under TLR. So if you do have to replace something, you're going to automatically step up to that race-worthy TLR standard in a part. So there's a benefit right there. Kind of getting back to the electronics package, it's got a Losi high torque digital servo in there as well. Of course, the battery's not included, we just have it in there for show. You get all that and so much more with a price tag right around $399. Currently, the ETA we're looking at to have this thing available is looking like September. So you'll be able to pick one up at that point. One final thing is it's going to come with the choice of two different colored bodies. The blue that you see here or also a black. Take that blue, replace with a black. It's a pretty hot looking paint job there. So when this thing comes out, go out and get one. Depending on what you're looking for, if you're looking for a less inexpensive way to get into racing, it's all right here in one package. You don't want to step up to the TLR version right off the bat, having to finish that out. All right here in one convenient package. So get out there and get racing.
Thanks a bunch, Andy. And if this car handles anywhere near what the Team Losi Racing version does, this is going to be one competitive, ready to run right out of the box. No need to really add a whole lot of anything. Great, great platform here. Next this week from ParkZone is we have this guy here. This is called the Pole Cat, and it's from ParkZone. It's an ultra micro airplane. If you guys enjoy like the Reno air races and pylon racers and things along those lines, this is going to be the kind of plane that you're going to want to look at. Very similar in styling and performance to some of the other ultra micros that are out there, but still has a very unique racy sort of look to it. Seth Arnold is the man behind this plane here, and he recently visited with us to give us some more information on the Polecat.
This is the Ultra Micro Polecat from ParkZone, brand new Ultra Micro just released. It's based off of a full-scale airplane that's raced in Reno races and pylon racing and that kind of thing. And it's a great flying airplane. It's fun to go around and shoot, you know, circuits around the light post at the local park or whatever, you know, but at the same time it's a very friendly, forgiving airplane, so it's great for sport aerobatics, loops, rolls, spins, touch and goes, all kinds of fun stuff. The airplane flies great. It's a really fun airplane. But uses all the same basic equipment, other micros, Spectrum micro receiver 6400, 8.5 millimeter brush motor. Just like I said, overall great flying airplane. This airplane is actually going to come as just a bind and fly. It'll come with a battery, E-flite 150 milliamp 1S battery and a single cell charger. It also come with the AA batteries in the box for the charger as well, so you don't have to put anything like that in there. It's a similar airplane to the Sukhoi, but the Sukhoi is a much more advanced aerobatic airplane. You can do a lot more with the Sukhoi than you can with this. You know, as I mentioned before, it's kind of a great sport aerobatic airplane. You know, the Sukhoi does some sport aerobatic stuff, but you can also go that little extra level and do some aerobatic stuff a little bit more capable with that airplane. This airplane should be available mid-July. Should be $99 for a bind and fly version. Like I said, you know, comes with the charger and battery and batteries for the charger as well. Standard construction like the rest of the ultra micro airplanes. Just the standard foam. You know, make sure you use foam safe kicker and CA on it when you fix it, a little bit of clear tape, that kind of thing. But it's a great little airplane. Hope you guys enjoy it.
Thanks a lot, Seth. I'm looking at the Pole Cat as for something for if you guys want to go out and fly something other than an ultra micro warbird, but still want that kind of flight performance. That's where the Pole Cat would kind of line up for you. Finally, this week we have a new Cessna from E-flite, and there's some unique stories behind this plane here. This plane is brought to us by David Payne, who was the product developer behind this. The paint scheme, trim scheme that you see on it, this is actually his father's plane, which is really a nice story to have combined with this. It is a 250 size ARF. It's called the Cessna 150. 250 size ARF. The Cessna 150 Aerobat 250 is for RC pilots wanting the thrill of basic aerobatics in a small package. This all-wood model is beautifully detailed. Now for the power system in this plane, E-flite does also have a new Park 280 sized brushless motor specifically for the Cessna, but you can obviously use it in other planes and models of this size and configuration. So that's going to do it for us this week on the Horizon. We thank you all for watching. We're sorry it took so long to bring you guys this Spitfire, but it's here now. I know you guys are going to love it. The 22 Ready to Run is going to be an awesome car out there on the track. The Polecat, the Cessna, just four great products coming to you this week. Now take care and have some fun with hobbies.